Hello all, welcome in this SAP video tutorial. Today's our discussion topic is how to get the purchase requisition list in SAP. Also, you will get the data of the purchase order with respect to purchase requisition. Means after purchase requisition, you have created the purchase order. So all the data available in this report, okay? How to get this data? You need to execute the transaction code ME5A and scope of list. You need to fill ALV, plan code 3002 is my plan code, release date, material groups, vendors. There is various option available here. Okay, so let's do practical. Transaction code is ME Mechanical 5A. Okay. I repeat again, transaction code is ME 5A. Here you need to choose the scope of list as ALV. You can also choose from drop down also. Plan code is 3002. Okay. You can choose the release date, because once the purchase requisition is released, then effectively it is applicable for creation of the purchase order. Okay, 1st April 2019 to 31st May 2019. I have taken a 1 or 2 month interval. Short indicator is shorting by purchase requisition numbers and items. There are 9 shorting criterias. Okay. So you can choose accordingly. Okay, you can also choose the fixed vendor, desired vendors, purchase group, material. Okay, I'm going to execute this transaction code. See, in this column, purchase order, purchase order date, ordered, purchase requisition, quantity, plan, requisitioner, tracking number, agreement number, release date, price, total price, okay, agreement numbers. Okay, there are various other columns available in the right hand side. If you want to include any of these columns, then you can include this. For example, I just want to include the fund centers in our report. So fund center is available here in our report. For example, if the purchase order dates, for this, with respect to this purchase requisition, there is a purchase order created on this date. Okay, so you can check the purchase order data also with respect to purchase requisition. Okay, you can also find out for which purchase requisition we have not created the purchase order yet. Okay, I'm running this transaction code again. Okay, ALB. Okay, going in the dynamic selection, going in the purchase requisition tab, and checking the data of fixed vendors and desired vendor. For fixed vendor, if you can fill multiple number of the codes. For example, I'm just filling the one of the vendor code 1064621. Okay, another vendor code I just filling is 1062444. Okay, and just want to get the data of the purchase requisition with these vendors and release date from, again, 1st April 2019 to 31st May 2019. I just want to get the data of purchase requisition against these vendors. Okay, I'm just going to execute. Okay, see, the data is only available for these two vendors. Okay, vendor code is not available, so I'm just clicking on the fixed vendor including in our list. Okay, see, for two purchase requisition available for the 444 vendor and two purchase requisition available for 621 vendors, and respective amount is there. There is no purchase order further created. Okay, so hope you understand how we can extract the data of purchase requisition in SAP, and the all the data associated in the purchase requisition, like purchase order, link with the purchase order in which purchase requisition is showing here. Okay, there are various other options like cost centers, WBS elements, order, asset serve number, network criteria. So depending on your requirement, like depending on your account assignment category, you can find out the data of purchase requisition in any plant. Okay, so I hope you understand these things. Okay, these are account assignment. Okay, if I'm talking about the WBS element, if we have released the external processing activity, network activity in the release mode, a background purchase requisition will generate, and that purchase requisition will be used in the creation of the purchase order. Okay, for example, if I'm just filling any material code, okay, I just want to find out the data of the purchase requisition with respect to these materials. Okay. Okay. Two material code I just want to include. Okay. One more material code. You can fill multiple number of the material codes. Okay. Okay. And just going to execute the data. So these are the purchase requisition with respect to these materials we have created in SAP in this plant, okay, for various operational expenses or capital expenses. Okay, so hope you understand. I just want to include the material code in our report. Okay, so come in that. Material code is already available in this report. This is the material code. Okay, this is the material code. Okay, power meter, optical, 4 fiber OFC cables and all. Okay, so thanks. You just want to apply the subtotal on the regard. Okay, so you can apply. I just want to apply the subtotal. Okay, okay, I've applied the subtotal. So depending on the subtotal criteria, we have get the regard of the purchase requisition. Okay, for this material and this material. Okay, these are the total value and okay. So this is all about how you can create the purchase, how you can get the data of the purchase requisition using transaction code ME5A in SAP. Hope you understand all the things what we have explained. Okay, if you have any query in your mind, then please mention in the comment section or reach us at erpsapteam1@gmail.com. okay, please share this knowledge with your colleagues and friends. Okay, still if you have any doubts, again please mention in the comment sections. Okay, if you are new in our YouTube channel erpsapteam, please subscribe our YouTube channel and don't forget to press the bell icon. Okay, thanks for watching. See you in the next video. Have a nice day.